Hi, I've decided to do this clip now instead of a little bit later this evening. I started cooking a dish called Poulet Colombo. And it's a Caribbean dish. I think the Colombo is a reference to the city in Sri Lanka. And, I wanted to show you. I had some big bags of rice stored here away from mice. It's this Thai rice, 5 kilograms. And it's lasted me 2 years, and the price of rice has not gone up here at all, as far as I can tell. Which is probably why I'm still able to do some business exporting staple foods to the United States. And even with my markup, it's still a good deal for people over there. I've got some chicken thighs cooking here. I'm only doing 4 at a time because I don't want to crowd them. They're browning in a little oil. There are a total of 8, and they have macerated, marinated, and for 24 hours in lime juice, olive oil, salt, and pepper. And I've got here some of that rice, which you don't want to peek very often at rice. Put a little oil in the bottom of the pot, heat it up, add the rice, stir it around until it starts to get translucent, add some boiling water, and then I added some, what did I do? Did I throw it out already? Yes, I did. I've added some coconut milk, unsweetened coconut milk. Oh, there's some nice noise coming from somebody doing some work somewhere. And this rice is cooking under a low flame, over a low flame. Don't peek more than once or twice. Right before all the liquid is absorbed, turn off the flame, let it sit there, and finish steaming. Once this chicken is browned, I'll do these 4 pieces, then I'll do the other 4. Make sure the oil is nice and hot, so if they don't stick to the bottom of the pot. This is a cocotte, a Dutch oven. It has a lid, which you will need. And the other ingredients are going to be finely minced onion, a little thinly sliced carrot. This is optional. The onion is not optional. This is a corn de boeuf pepper. It's a medium pepper. It's really not hot. This is going to be deveined, deseeded, and sliced. This is a courgette, as they call them here. It's a zucchini. It will be scrubbed and sliced. This is a rather sad-looking potato. It's got some scars on it. I'm going to peel it and dice it. I've got a little bit of leftover ratatouille here. I'm not sure if I'm going to add this or not because there's a little tomato in it, and this recipe does not call for tomato. These are some cumin seeds. These are whole seeds. I will add these. This is the last of my, just about the last of my spices from Turkey. Most recipes for this call for a big branch of thyme and a couple of fresh bay leaves. I don't have any, so I'm using Herbe de Provence. I can get this for you if you want it, because it has crushed bay leaf and thyme in it. Lots of fresh cilantro from my window box, which I will chop. This is an antilles pepper. The French call the Caribbean the antilles. You don't chop this. You don't open it. It's too hot. It's going to get added whole. And this is the most important ingredient besides the meat, Colombo mix. Again, I can get this for you if you don't find it. You've got to have a couple of big spoonfuls of this in there. Then I will add enough water to cover it, and I will cover it with a lid and cook it for about 20 to 30 minutes until the vegetables soften. I've also seen that you can use eggplants as the vegetables. This is a very spicy dish. If you have pain issues, don't eat any of the nightshade family, which is most of these things, including chilies or, you know, spicy things. If you have painful periods or arthritis or gout or even bad headaches, just avoid all that. But my spouse likes this, so I'm making it for him. And the cooking time is not very long. The marinating time is really recommended to be 24 hours. This was in the refrigerator with a bowl over it. All right, I hope you're all well. I don't edit or provide links, so you won't even see how this comes out, but I will annotate if it came out bad. Bye-bye. Oh, lime juice, not lemon juice. Bye-bye.